some of the gals who work here literally got dressed up because they knew Ricky Whittle was coming. And he's delivered, and then he walks in, and Jessica's like, oh, Ricky, you smell so nice.
Well, he does.
You guys, stop.
You're so wonderful. Before we flatter Ricky too much, though, and we'll get to American Gods, which people really have great appreciation for, I have highlighted it for you. Here is the question they have submitted. It is in yellow.
Oh, that's mean. Guys, come on. That's outrageous. Do you prefer American or British girls?
Oh, boy.
I mean, I don't like to discriminate against any.
There we go.
But
there are Brazilians out there.
Yes.
Canadian.
Yes.
You know Charlize Theron is looking.
Yes.
Did you hear about this?
Have you heard this?
You guys. Yeah. Find the Charlize.
My hat is in.
Yeah. You know what?
Hat is in.
No, let's do.
Put me in, coach.
Yeah.
I bumped into her actually at the Austin, the South by Southwest when we were promoting season 2 of American Gods.
Right.
And she is stunning in person.
But men are afraid. Afraid to ask her out, and she has been terribly single.
She looks like a goddess herself.
Right. She could be.
Are you speed dialing her now?
I could be.
Fantastic.
She was on Entertainment Tonight yesterday, and she said men do. She's hopelessly single.
All right. Mm.
And
here, we'll put it up. Let me show you. This is the direct quote from Charlize herself. Pop it up on the screen. This could be a match. It could work out very well.
We're pimping out on KTLA. Yeah.
It'd be a beautiful couple.
Oh, there's that. Oh, that's it.
She looks really different. I mean, I'm into her.
Is it
strange I find her attractive?
Wow, we're going to get in trouble.
She works out.
She wasn't wearing a shirt.
I have been single for 10 years.
That's
somebody
a lie.
Somebody just needs to grow a pair and step up. I am shockingly available.
There you
Charlize,
go.
Charlize, I am in. I am
done.
I'm texting you now. I don't have your number, but in my head I do. Goodness.
It's a 310 number.
No, I can understand. I mean, she's stunning.
And, right.
She's a very talented woman.
And do you
that's intimidating for some people.
Right, but not intimidating for you.
I'd be honored. That, I mean, she's an incredible woman.
Honored.
It's.
I'd be honored to date you.
No, but I think in relationships, you should always be, you know, proud of your partner.
Yeah.
And
of course.
You shouldn't be intimidated by something.
Right.
You should push your partner to be as great as possible in whatever it is that they choose to do or be, you know, whether it be just working, whether it be a mother, whether it be a big career, a small career, whatever they want to do, just let them follow their passions. Be there for
ladies,
them.
The right answer. all right. For this potential relationship, would you prefer women in the business or, as we describe, civilians?
That's a tough one because women in the business realize that we're very, we're always spread out around the world. Mm-hmm. You know, we're always filming it here and there and everywhere, and there's a lot of trust and security that you need to give to that person. But actors are a little bit crazy.
Right.
We're very emotional. We're always on the edge for our craft. And people who are not in the industry are just a lot more normal and relaxed and fun. But at the same time, it's hard to explain that, you know, you can't just take days off. You know, you can be the best surgeon in the world, but you can always have the second best surgeon. You know, that's how I put it. Whereas an actor, a musician, it's kind of our face, and so therefore, we can't just take days off. And I remember doing a scene where I was very sick and I was performing the scene. We'd cut, I would, vomit, brush my teeth, and then would go again. And then we'd cut, I would vomit, brush my teeth, and go again. I had to do an action scene with a dislocated shoulder, and I had to hold my belt like as if I was holding my pants up or something, but it was actually for my actual safety of my shoulder to keep it kind of in place. You have to go through all this sort of stuff. Ooh. So, you know, it doesn't matter what my partner will do. It's as long as, you know, they're supportive and they're.
This is the crazy thing. We wear these little earpieces, and our producer Fawaz is screaming these two words, I'm in. whatever's going on.
Yeah.
American Gods picked up very popular. We're going to look at a clip in just a second. Your television wife came back from the dead. And now you're dealing with the reality of her return?
Yeah, I'm stuck in a Shadow Moon, and I'm stuck in a world of gods, leprechauns, dead wives, and he doesn't believe in any of it. So we watch this story through Shadow's eyes. So at the beginning, our audience is confused too. Mm. But as Shadow starts to figure this out, we let our audience in, and they start to figure it out together. It's a very unique way of watching a television show. And so now we move into season 2. We just got picked up for season 3 as well. So we've got legs to go for a few years. It's a very famous book by Neil Gaiman, an incredible author, probably a rock star of the book world. And he seems to think we've got a good 5 seasons to go to finish his book. So it's going to be a lot of fun. And we've got a great family there on American Gods,
right,
in front and behind the camera.
Charlize, take this in. It's Ricky at work.
What? Season three. Let's bring her in. Season three, Charlize. See, we can
I lost everyone.
Give you a job.
Everyone that I ever cared about. Everything I knew. To a point where I forgot who I was. Lost my light. That's what my mom would have said. Wednesday. Odin.
All right, Jessica said even the clip smelled good.
Yeah.
So it's all going well. American Gods is Sunday on Starz. Welcome back anytime. Yeah. I'm an Thank excellent you. Cupid. I've done this many times with famous
Hey, people. I did this.
Yeah, you did.
I'm sorry you know about what? That.
He wants credit. Yeah.
The wedding, I just came back from my brother's wedding.
Right.
I'm a very good wedding planner, but you're all invited.
Oh, okay. Rick, thank you so much.
Done. Done. You hit it first. Yes. Rick and Charlize.
How much money do you spend on the Crest's whitening strips?
On the whitening strips? Well, I'm British. We don't have, you know, good teeth. So, yeah, so this, I've had a little bit of...
They literally, you can hear the sound, bing.
That's don't even need the star. It's there naturally.
Yeah. You're a good sport.
You're great.
We love
Thank you very much for having me.